day.
All right, Tom, thank you. Americans are finally starting to see their paychecks grow, and the FDA has approved a cannabis-based drug to treat epilepsy. Jane King has these stories and so much more. It's today's Business Report.
The monthly jobs report saw more job growth than expected. The Labor Department says 250,000 jobs were created last month. We expected 190,000. The government says the hurricanes did not have an impact on jobs. Now, many parts of the economy added jobs in October. Leisure and hospitality, healthcare, manufacturing, construction, transportation, even mining added workers. Americans' paychecks also grew by 3.1%. That was the biggest increase since April 2009. Well, the first marijuana-based medication approved by the FDA officially became available for sale in all 50 states yesterday. Epidiolex is made by GW Pharma. It's derived from a plant that has been bred to have a high CBD content. It does not, however, contain the THC part of marijuana that gets people high. It will be available for prescription for kids ages 2 and up in an effort to curb the long-lasting effects of seizure disorders. Whole Foods, catering to vegans for the holiday season, it's partnered with award-winning chef Jeremy Fox, author of a cookbook on vegetables, to launch a holiday meal. It's entirely vegan. It includes cauliflower, mushrooms, acorn squash, and sweet potatoes. And UPS is warning shippers to brace for a freight strike. The disruption could come after a union vote next week. The freight workers have already rejected the contract once. UPS says it can only guarantee shipments through Thursday. From the NASDAQ, I'm Jane King with your business update.
All right, Jane, thanks so much. Let's take a look, see how stocks are performing right now after the rally all week. We're going down here a little bit, down 128 points to sit right now at 25,252. NASDAQ Composite also slipping down 79 points to sit at 73.54. Subaru and Toyota recalling cars with a defect that could lead to engine stalling. Subaru and Toyota recalling about 165,000 vehicles after discovering valve springs could fracture and cause the engine to stall, risking an accident, maybe even severe engine damage. The recalled models include certain versions of the Subaru Impreza 4D and 5D, the Subaru XV Crosstrek, the Subaru BRZ, and the Scion FRS. All of the cars were made in 2012 and 2013. According to Subaru, it was not aware of any crashes or injuries connected to the defect. Toyota declined comment. Black & Decker, Bosch, and Porter Cable hammer drills and drill drivers are being recalled due to an injury hazard. The side handle can break or slip, leading to a loss of control of the tool. Black & Decker has received 11 reports of side handles slipping or breaking and one report of a torn rotator cuff injury. 614,000 were sold online and in major home and hardware stores from 2010 to July of 2018. Consumers should immediately stop using the drills and contact Black & Decker for a free replacement side handle. Well, now that Halloween is behind us, retailers are officially all in for the mad dash to Black Friday. Target announced Thursday it will open stores an hour earlier this year, that's 5 p.m. on Thanksgiving Day, to give shoppers an early start on holiday shopping. They'll close at 1 a.m. and reopen at 7 a.m. for Black Friday. Target also unveiled its ad for the big shopping day, detailing the bargains and deals that consumers can start to plan for. Also, Target is reporting it too will have new mobile checkout options following a similar announcement earlier this week from Walmart. Workers at both stores will use handheld devices to scan items and speed transactions. Researchers say an alarming number of families are saving and sharing antibiotics. Their findings are based on a poll of about 500 parents. About half said that they had kept leftover antibiotics instead of properly disposing of them. Three quarters of the parents then shared the extras with other family members or friends. 16% say that they had given their child antibiotics originally prescribed for an adult. And soft padded furniture may not seem dangerous, but more kids get hurt falling from sofas and beds than tumbling down the stairs. A new study from Texas Children's Hospital shows more than 230,000 kids under the age of 5 are treated for soft furniture injuries each year. Many of the injuries are to the head and face, and while severe traumas are rare, about 3% of children are hospitalized. Chris?
All right, I know. Halloween is over.